Good morning, everyone. Today is Friday, 10 o'clock, and we are going to talk about Agarwood. So I'm coming from Rural Asset, and my brand names are Olia and Oriwood Asia. The company, the marketing company, is called Signature. So we have been doing Agarwood for 10 years or more. So today, what is the topic about? Today, topic is about what is Agarwood? Real Agarwood or not real Agarwood? Who are the real Agarwood people? Who are not? Why? The reason I say that was yesterday I was talking to a prospect in Riyadh, and his first reaction was, how you know your Agarwood is real? Because Malaysia, Riyadh, right? And then we don't know each other. How I know it's real? So I explained everything about what we have. We have factory, we have plantation. Then he say, how I know you are real company or maybe just a dealer or a reseller or a broker? So basically, I think this concept or this mentality is quite common in Agarwood people. People are very suspicious of each other. People are wary of each other. I think it's sad, but that people treat Agarwood industry like this. But the most important part is, even though people are suspicious or whatever, they don't know how to ask. They don't know how to verify information. So I think a better way is for us to go through what are the international verification about Agarwood. Now, we hear this all the time, even though when we say we sell you oil, no, we sell oil. So here is a Malaysian Pontian oil that we are selling. People say real or not real, or even when we say we sell beads to people, right? They say, is it real or not real? So it's very common. Now, many people in the agave industries, they go by using the association. So we also got this, I'm also a committee member of this China Association of Agarwood. They use my association, but that is a bit, to me, that is a bit of not following the proper way. I mean, there are associations, and there are so many associations, by the way, and they are also koperasi. People try to position themselves and they show their name, oh, I'm a chairman of this koperasi, I'm a chairman of this association. But to me, is that really portray you as someone who actually knows Agarwood, or someone who actually deals in Agarwood? Chairman of koperasi, chairman of association. Well, there are so many chairmans and there are so many koperasi and association around. So I think let's go back to fundamentals. How do the international market look at Agarwood? Now, many people think, ask questions like, for example, oh, is Agarwood an endangered species? How did the world control? How did they do that? How did they? I think today's topic, we will talk about that. So basically, Agarwood is an endangered species. Okay, endangered. And it is controlled by this international international convention on the protection of this exotic flora fauna. And in the CITES schedule, Agarwood is under schedule 2. What does schedule 2 means? Schedule 2 means that you can export. It's not that you cannot export, you can, but every country, there is the limit on how much you can export. So that's how the international community under CITES, under United Nations, control so that Agarwood do not become extinct. So they control every country who signed up with them, has to make sure that every country will not export more than what is approved. So Malaysia got its approval, used to be, I think, 200 tons, and now seems to be dropping down because our resources is less, so they allocate us less. So that's how the international body control. Now, a bit more details. How do we go about it? Okay. So the body in Malaysia who sign up with the international one is called MTIB, or Malaysia Timber Industry Board. under Ministry of Primary Resources. Yeah. The actual board is called Malaysia Timber Industry Board, or MTIB for short, right? So they signed up. So they are the one who is called the Management Authority. So every country has a management authority. The management authority will manage this whole thing. So Underwood is under Schedule 2 of CITES and is protected, and you still can trade, you still can export, but it's the limit. Okay. And it is controlled by MTIB, Management Authority. Now, there are three parties involved in Malaysia. MTIB is a management authority. Now, FRIM, Forest Research Institute of Malaysia, is the scientific authority. Meaning to say that FRIM is the one who will determine, yes, this is Agarwood, no, this is Agarwood. So stuff like this. Now, the one that will so-called catch you, or you know, who take care of the forest, is a forestry department. In Malay, it's called Jabatan Perhutanan Semenanjung Malaysia, JPSM. So it's a forestry department who take care of the jungle forest, right? So in the event that they make a search on you, the party who come in, look for you is the Jabatan Perhutanan. So if you have wood, carrying the wood across city, across state, if you are stopped by the Jabatan Perhutanan, you have to prove that why do you have the wood in your car. So under the international CITES law, one person cannot carry, especially normally in Malaysia, not a problem, but when you cross country, you are not allowed to carry more than 2 tola of oil. More than two of this. So 1 tola is about 12 ml, so your maximum 2, means 24 ml. And if you carry wood block, then it's not more than 1 kg. If you carry this subjective, you can say that it's a give or whatever, but if you carry 100 of this, then there'll be a problem. Right, so basically, the authority is these three: MTIB, Jabatan Perhutanan, and FRIM. So what happened? Let's say you are being caught by Jabatan Perhutanan, right? So the person that come and catch you is Jabatan Perhutanan. But the person who will, when you go to court, the person who will testify, yes, this is Agarwood, is FRIM. Now, the person who will sue you in court is MTIB. So this is how it works, right? MTIB is the management authority. The Jabatan Perhutanan is someone catch you. FRIM is someone who's confirm that you are, this is the Agarwood, and MTIB will sue you in court. So this is how the three party works. Okay, next thing. How do MTIB control this whole community, right? So basically, when you want to chop down you want to chop down from the forest, you need the forest license, right? From the Jabatan Perhutanan, they give you the pas pindah. Okay, pas pindah is a pass that allow you to pindah from one state to another state. It's still controlled by the state, right? Not national, it's still the state. So we have to deal with the Jabatan Perhutanan Pahang, if our plantation in Pahang, have to deal with Jabatan Perhutanan in Terengganu, your plantation in Terengganu, and so on, Kelantan, and so every different state have its own Jabatan Perhutanan. Like Pahang, I got land in Bentong area, which is in Karak, part of Bentong. So I got to deal with the daerah, which is actually Karak, not daerah, the Mukim, it's actually Karak. Then it goes to the Bentong as the daerah. Then I go to the Pahang, the Kuantan there for the Pahang state. So that this is the level that they have. Now, how do MTIB control? First, they control the penanam. People like us who achieve tanam the pokok. They control penanam. So what they do is that when you planted the tree, okay, if you got 10 trees, no problem. I think 200 is the minimum. So if you plant more than 200 pokok, you actually got to apply permit from Jabatan Perhutanan, from MTIB. They will come and inspect your trees. Then they will give you a license, something like this, right? This is the license. So basically from MTIB, it says that this is rural asset development. So until it says here that bahawa Lembaga Perlindungan Kayu Malaysia, which is NKB, selaku pihak berkuasa pengurusan. Pihak berkuasa pengurusan means they are the management authority of CITES. Okay, so under the jadual that the regarding species, they allow us, syarikat seperti mana di atas, this company, membiak atau menyimpan species di bawah. So they actually give us the approval to plant, membiak or menyimpan. So if I got the species in our possession in our company, it's okay. So they control by the penanam. So in the first place, you have to be a penanam. Right. Now, what if your trees are old enough and then you want to start harvesting? You got to go to Jabatan Perhutanan. Even though it's your own land, your own tree, you got to go to Jabatan Perhutanan to apply that you want to tebang your pokok and then you want to export or you want to process. So you need the Jabatan Perhutanan to come inspect and then to give you a pas pindah. Pas pindah for you to pindah your harvest. So this is how they control this. Now, the last thing, what if you got customer in overseas who wants to Zama is online. Hi, Zama. Okay, Zama is the officer from MTIB. So what if it's 150 ton, right? Yeah. This year is 150 ton. What if you have overseas customer who wants to buy your product? So actually, we still need to go to MTIB and apply for this peng export. So in this case, real estate development, we are the approved peng export and peng bekal. So we can supply and export. This is the difference. Huh? This one is export. This one is tanam. So we have to go to MTIB again to apply for export. So without, because MTIB work with CITES, so MTIB will give us the export permit of CITES so that we can export. And when we export, we got the CITES certificate, then the importer will also need to inform the CITES over there that they are importing. So basically, this is how CITES control. Basically, MTIB, when you tanam, MTIB will approve you tanam. When the tree grow big already, you want to potong, harvest, Jabatan Perhutanan will approve you to harvest, and then they will show you how many batang you harvest, and you got to show this to the MTIB again, that I want to export. Then MTIB will say confirm, these are your oil and your wood, and they will allow your export with certain quantity. From there, you have to get the importer, you got to inform who is the importer, who is the this, and then from there you actually can export legally. Now talking about this is all legally processed and it is quite a controlled environment. So we hope that with this, agar tree can prosper and we let more and more people enjoy the real agar. Okay, that's it for today. A bit technical. I hope I try to explain as much as possible in about 10 minutes. And if you got more questions, please feel free to ask me further. Okay, thank you very much. And thank you, NTIB, for supporting us. Thank you.